Well, it is now November, and tis the season to be stressed. So today I want to share a few strategies for managing stress and bringing peace to your holiday season. Hello, my charmed ones, and welcome back to my channel for another video. And if this is your first time with me, I would like to say welcome. My name is Alexis, but I'm also known as Miss Trenchcoat all across the internet. I'm an online entrepreneur who designs and sells productivity tools, strategies, and skills to help you manifest success with less stress. So if that sounds interesting to you, I'll leave some links down below in the description box where you can check out more of my work online. And feel free to download some of my latest free productivity tools over at thecharmshop.com. So we have now entered the holiday season, that final 2 months of the year where we have a whole bunch of holidays that end up causing so many people a sense of stress for a variety of reasons. So I thought I'd put together this seasonal stress survival guide with some of my best tips and strategies for helping you beat the stress and finding a mental peace of mind during the holiday time. So my first tip for you, if you find that you're getting stressed out this holiday season, is to prioritize your mental peace of mind. It's so easy during the holiday season to get overwhelmed with extra tasks because we always want to say yes and incorporate more into our holidays. But if you aren't managing your mental capacity, more events and more people, tasks, and even more blessings will just end up spilling over and mentally drowning you. So to help manage your peace of mind, here are three strategies that you can do to increase your mental capacity. Number one is to meditate for 30 minutes a day. Meditation doesn't have to be complicated. The best way that I find to meditate is to put on some headphones and listen to a guided meditation track when I wake up in the morning or right before I go to sleep at night. Now, I know we hear a lot about meditation and different stats for how long to meditate, but I have to say that through a lot of research, I found that really 30 minutes is a good sweet spot to start with. So if you can just carve out 30 minutes a day for meditation, it will go a long way for giving you a sense of mental peace of mind, increase your capacity to take on issues and to problem solve and to manage your own stress, and will ultimately help you have a better season. Strategy number two is gratitude journaling. Again, journaling doesn't have to be difficult. Simply listing out one thing every day that you're thankful for can really go a long way. As they say, every day isn't good, but there's something good in every day. And if you keep that saying in mind, you will see your mental capacity increase. Strategy number three is to use your planner to brain dump regularly. If you find the holiday season gets you overwhelmed due to an additional amount of information and obligations that cause you stress, making sure to brain dump and writing down all the information that you're holding onto in your mind will absolutely help you get your head clear and to make sure that you are keeping your tasks and events organized in your planner. So if your planner doesn't already have some designated brain dump section, you can get my Brilliant Ideas Build Your Own Planner inserts that include my brain dump sheets that you can use on a regular basis to keep your mental space clear of clutter. I will have that linked down below for you in the description box. Now, my second tip for you to manage your stress during the holiday season is to get an immunity boost. And strategy number one for this is to think about getting the flu shot. Now, I'm not a doctor, but it's a highly recommended activity that most people get a flu shot every year. Now, in the past, I will admit that I've been someone that has been very anti-flu shot. That was until I had this very long discussion with a friend of mine who is a doctor, and she really was able to convince me why it really is essential for me to get my flu shot every year, because it really does have a positive cumulative effect on you. So if you are someone who is eligible to get a flu shot, definitely take advantage of that. If you're not sure, absolutely go see your doctor or phone into your doctor's office and see if that's an option for you, because it can be a very big stress saver for you to have that boost in your immunity during a time of year where a lot of people are getting sick, and knowing how stress can deteriorate you, it's very useful to have a flu shot. Now, strategy number two for this is to use essential oils to fortify your immune system. I have this lovely blend blend of essential oils from Sage Wellness that's actually called Fortify. And I've been using it for years now to help me stay safe from seasonal germs and viruses, and then also help me to mitigate or tame symptoms on the rare occasion that I do actually get sick or fall under the weather. You will definitely want to do your research with essential oils, but generally speaking, things like frankincense, eucalyptus, tea tree oil, and lavender are a great place to start for fortifying your body topically. Again, I want to specify that I wouldn't recommend just running out and buying any essential oils and then just applying it, because that can have some harmful side effects if you're using the wrong types of oils in the wrong types of ways. So I will go ahead and I will leave a link down below in the description box to an article that is a really great resource for understanding essential oils, what they're good for, and how to actually use them properly. And strategy number three for giving yourself an immunity boost is to make sure you're taking a daily multivitamin. Again, I'm not a doctor, and most of you probably don't need me to remind you of this, but taking a multivitamin is a great way to fortify your immune system and to help keep you healthy during the stressful winter months. If you are not already taking a multivitamin, definitely talk to your doctor about perhaps the best one for you to take, because I really can't be giving each one of you guys a recommendation on that. But I do think that for me, using a multivitamin has been very helpful for helping me to supplement vitamins and nutrients that I may not be getting in through my diet. And bonus, this tip is really going to help you all year long if you get into the habit of using a multivitamin. So start now. You'll thank me later. Now, the third and final tip I have for you for managing your stress during the holiday season is to stock up on shortcuts. So the first strategy I have for you in this area is to get yourself some crock pot meals. So during the fall and winter months, specifically, I like to use my crock pot on a weekly basis to help me prep meals and save myself time and money in the kitchen. I have done a video on some of my favorite crock pot recipes in the past. I'll leave that link down below in the description box. But I also welcome you to follow me on Pinterest, because I have some Pinterest boards where I like to put crock pot meals. So that is really where I find a lot of my recipe inspiration. So if you want to follow along with me there, I'll leave a link down below as well. Strategy number two for stocking up on your shortcuts is to find a quick go-to workout routine. Again, Pinterest is great for finding those sort of 5 to 7 minute HIIT workouts. So HIIT actually stands for high intensity interval training, and it's a type of routine that gives you a maximum benefit for a minimum amount of time of working out. So usually under 15 to 30 minutes, but I've definitely seen workout routines that are like 5 to 7 minutes. So it's just another great way to help you to keep yourself fit and save yourself time. If you're someone who wants to start working out, I definitely recommend finding one of those quick workouts on Pinterest. And finally, strategy number three for stocking up on shortcuts is to invest in some sort of time-saving cleaning gadgets. Now, I love my Robo vacuum because I love that I can set it up and it cleans my floors for me. Now, I'm also totally in love with my simple Swiffer sweeper, because the first level of my house is mostly hardwood floors, and it's so easy for me to sweep and mop with one tool for household cleaning, and it's super portable. I'll go ahead and leave links down below in the description box to the gadgets that I'm using, but I just love any sort of home care gadgets that make chores easier for me, because chores are like my least favorite thing to do during the week, but there's something that I think all of us need to do. So anytime that we can save time cleaning our home, especially in the holiday season, that is so helpful, because I'm always having people in and out of my house, especially during the holidays. So if I can use something that helps me like save time quickly cleaning up, that is such a time and stress saver. So those are my three tips and a total of 9 strategies that you can use to manage your seasonal stress. Now, in order to make this process easier for you, I've actually put together a little free download worksheet or cheat sheet, however you'd like to think about it, with all of these tips and strategies on there, plus a little bit of additional information to help you get started. Of course, the link to download that will be down in the description box, so definitely check it out if you want to have a little cheat sheet that you can keep in your planner or in your kitchen for you to stimulate these ideas and make sure that you are prioritizing your mental peace of mind, boosting your immunity, and stocking up on shortcuts to help you manage stress during the holiday season. Now, I want to hear from you. Which one of these tips or strategies are you most excited to try out? Leave me a comment down below in the description box. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it with whomever you think would find it helpful. For more behind the scenes of my productivity life and business, make sure you're following me on Instagram at Miss Trenchcoat. And if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button for more awesome videos by me. And until next time, bye-bye.